Shout out to our sponsor, Dollar Shave Club.
See why over 3 million members love Dollar Shave Club. They're so confident in their quality of all their products. Now you can get your first month of the club for free. Just pay shipping.
And after that, there's just a few bucks a month. No long-term commitment, no hidden fees. Get yours at dollarshaveclub.com/no.
Oh, no.
Welcome to The No, I'm Ashley Jenkins.
And I'm Miles Luna.
Good news, everyone. The late summer blockbuster game everyone has been looking forward to for years has broken another record.
Yes, we're talking about No Man's Sky.
Everyone's favorite.
The game that already broke the record for most played PC game of the year. Well, Hello Games has done it again. Another record.
Yeah, this time the record is a real doozy. It's now received the lowest possible rating on Steam with 88% negative reviews in the last 30 days.
Give him a hand, everybody.
Well done. Really 12% positive. That's better than expected.
All right, let's take a look at the newest entry in the saga of games that are more fun to follow in the news than to actually play.
Currently, the numbers sit at an overall mostly negative rating with 71,263 reviews, giving it the big old gladiator thumbs down. And as far as the recent reviews are concerned, well, it doesn't get any better.
No, it gets worse. Steam now prioritizes recent ratings in games more so than overall rating, as it gives potential customers a better idea of how the game is now, since patches are common these days and can drastically change the gameplay experience.
And the majority of the 5,392 recent reviews for No Man's Sky rate their play experience as negative, which has tagged the game as overwhelmingly negative, Steam's lowest possible category.
Overall, the game has a 32% positive rating since its release, so if anything, gamers have become more irate in the recent weeks than immediately after the game's launch.
So 32% down to 12%. Yeah, that's rough. Mm. Several users have left snappy, short reviews that really seem to capture the essence of their experience with No Man's Sky. For example, one user, the highbrower Force Poop, stated, "A mile wide, but an inch deep." Yeah, I feel you. Mm-hmm. "I cannot express it better," with 88% of users finding this particular review helpful. Oh, that's where all the negative, all the 88% thumbs down or all 88% thumbs up with this guy.
User Sonaris chimed in with the quote, "The perfect scam, bait players into playing past the refund deadline using false advertising so Steam won't refund the purchase. Profit? Welcome to the future of gaming, folks." End quote. 90% of people found this review helpful.
Yeah, it seems pretty well consistent with the overall sentiment about the game, actually, so I can get the 90% ups.
Even with this small and pretty bitter taste of what people were saying, it's clear that the majority of people who purchased the game felt that they didn't get what they paid for in any sense, so it's a very simple equation. Users plus major dissatisfaction means lowest rating on Steam.
Brigading! It's what you do. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare sends their sympathy.
All those dislikes. Has really blown my mind.
Oh, thanks, Sean Murray. Let's face it, most of these dislikes probably aren't because of the quality of the game itself. I mean, if you disregard all the marketing promises and just take the game as it is, the game is not overwhelmingly mm-hmm. negative. I give it a solid whelming. Traversing between planets, pretty cool. Upgrading ships and gear to better withstand the various conditions on all the planets is fun. Mining everything under the sun appeals to that inner pack rat. Even learning languages is kind of cool.
Yeah,
so there are some nuggets of not overwhelmingly negative in there.
Yeah, I'd agree with that. It's probably not the game so much as everything that's going on around the game. Technical issues aside, the complaints largely stem from users who feel intentionally misled by Hello Games founder Sean Murray's over-enthusiastic promises and focus on vision and mystery over, you know, the actual game.
Or that he continued to imply multiplayer functionality even after the game was released and gamers met up in the same place and then didn't see each other because there was no multiplayer functionality.
Yeah, or that the ending was worth all the trouble.
So yeah, some of the initial dissatisfaction was definitely because of, well, disappointment with what the game turned out to actually be, not to mention the bugs and the other glitches that made the game difficult to actually play for some. If there's one area that Hello Games actually has delivered, it's working to fix these kinds of bugs. They haven't shouted it from the rooftops or anything, but they have steadily been releasing updates. They've dropped at least 6 patches for PC and 3 or 4, I think, for PS4 to fix some of the more glaring, technical issues.
No signs yet of features, but your save file probably won't corrupt at least.
Oh good, I was real worried about that.
Thank God.
The reason this game is still sticking around actually isn't the lack of features so much anymore. We all know by now that the game isn't what was promised. Disappointing games, they happen all the time, and that's disappointing, but you know, we move on. Everyone who got excited spends a week or two frothing at the mouth in anger, and then we find something else to be angry about. Most games don't get this kind of focused vitriol for more than 2 months after their launch.
The reason people still care in this case isn't even about the game anymore. It's about being heard and acknowledged and treated like people rather than wallets. And with the developers all but disappearing from the internet in the wake of the game's release with virtually no acknowledgement, gamers have largely felt duped and ignored.
Yeah, and with good reason. Murray vanished from social media in mid-August after tweeting about how few people were having issues, which shows a certain tone deafness even at that point, and Hello Games hasn't communicated anything in weeks, and prior to that was just notifications about patch releases. No responses to gamers demanding answers, just silence and links to patch notes.
When the entire internet is shouting at you, it can be kind of scary to go out and say, hey. The confirmation that the team is working on new content didn't even come from the studio itself, but from the game's audio chief, Paul Weir, who tweeted in mid-September with the first mention of a planned content update for the game. And that was barely even a mention, but it's all we had so far, and everyone's latched onto it.
Yeah, since he's the only one talking, he's been fielding all kinds of questions from gamers over the studio's silence, from Sean Murray's health, he's apparently alive and well, by the way, to the planned content updates.
Unfortunately, just because he's talking doesn't mean he's in a position to give gamers the answers they want.
I mean, he's the audio chief, not the studio head.
Yeah, responding to a query today, he said, quote, I'm afraid I have nothing useful to say. It's entirely up to Hello or Sean as to when they want to talk publicly, end quote.
So count on more No Man's silence.
Yeah, it makes sense to some degree. If the developers know they don't have anything to say that would appease the mob, you know, there's been an increasing trend in brigading with the gaming community lately. Whether it's banding together to leave dislikes on an Infinite Warfare trailer
or every trailer.
Yeah. Or bomb Steam reviews to make a point. Gamers are doing more than voting with their wallets. They're making their voices heard, usually their displeasure, and not everyone is open to explanations. They just want to be mad.
You know what we need? We need like a good news brigade. People that just go around being happy about stuff.
No one cares about good news. Look, yeah, at televised news stations.
Unless it's like Battlefield 1.
Oh yeah, there's good news. It has a campaign. Okay, back to solving all the world's problems.
It does have a campaign. Well, maybe not solving problems, since no one can actually make Hello Games talk. And now that they're under scrutiny from the ASA over misleading advertising, not that the ASA can do much but wag a finger at them, they're probably even less likely to talk. Unless Jeff Keighley can get Murray on his new YouTube show, which everyone will watch. Everyone will watch that episode.
And then probably dislike it.
Well, of course. The thing is, as much as brigading could become a problem for the industry, it is kind of working to some extent, which is, I don't know, it could be a scary thing depending on how you think about it. It's not often you see a game take on a negative trend in overall owners on Steam, even with the 2-hour refund policy in place, but No Man's Sky is backsliding. Just in the last 2 weeks or so, the game's dropped almost 50,000 total owners.
That's the kind of thing that hurts the developer a lot more than a thumbs down. That comes out to somewhere in the neighborhood of $3 million in revenue, and that's just from refunds. It doesn't take into account potential sales that the negative reviews have warned off. Not that it leaves them in the poorhouse. They're still up $45 million from Steam sales alone, and we don't have any sales data for PS4, but that's still a lot of money.
Yeah, so folks, what's the solution to this? Aside from pipe dreams like delivering multiplayer and Pretty Planets and more gameplay, because let's be honest, those are gonna take years if we ever get them, how can a studio move past a disaster of this magnitude? Come on, be the guiding light of advice in the comments.
And for the next update in the saga of the game that's more fun to hate than it is to play, make sure you like this video and subscribe to the know, and that way you get it in your sub box.
Trust me, we'll let you know. Thanks to Dollar Shave Club for sponsoring this update.
DollarShaveClub.com delivers amazing razors right to your door, so you don't have to keep using the same dull razor because it's a pain to get them from the store.
It even gives you a really cool voice.
Yes.
They've got a whole lineup of razors too, so you can decide how fancy you want to get, plus extras like Dr. Carver's Shave Butter, Mint Cedarwood Body Cleanser, really nice smelling Amber Lavender Soap, or
Peppermint Tingly Butt Wipes.
Yeah.
It's Gus's favorite thing.
It's the real fun. Dollar Shave Club is so confident in the quality of all their products, and now you can get your first month of the club for free. You just pay shipping.
After that, it's just a few bucks a month, no long-term commitment, no hidden fees. There's no reason not to do it. Get yours at DollarShaveClub.com/no.
Be smooth.